illness in the fire service is growing at an alarming rate. The emerging crisis begs the question, who is there for our firefighters when they are the ones in need? In the final report of a three-part series, I found out what's being done to help them. It's known to be a silent killer.
You can't hide an injury. You can't hide forever the fact that you have cancer, but you can hide a mental illness very well.
More firefighters die each year by suicide than in the line of duty.
What we don't do a good job quantifying is this impact that the job has on firefighters over the course of their career in their mental state.
And mental illness is not a problem you should have to hide.
To know what the questions are that we need to answer and to know what red flags we need to look for, you know, that's as important as anything we do.
That's why the Rogers Fire Department participated in a nationwide study with the Center for Fire, Rescue, and EMS Health Research. The study started in 2015 and was completed this year. It looked at the chronic exposure to trauma and what it does to people in the fire service. Sarah Janke led the study.
I don't think anyone can see death and destruction. You know, children die, parents die on an everyday basis and not be affected by it in some way.
Janke says there are two main reasons for the growing rate of mental illness: a cultural stigma against mental health care and untreated mental health disorders.
And I think that being able to have those conversations and be honest about kind of where you're at with yourself and the people around you is important.
The study is helping to change workplace culture and how we think about mental health.
It has to be kind of an organic process to help people develop these skills and resources and really to develop a belief that they should do it, that they should be tuned in to how they're feeling and how other people are feeling, and then it matters.
For the first time ever, we're having conversations about mental health. You can back and look at fire academies 10, 20, 30 years ago. There was no talk and chapter and conversation about taking care of your mind.
It's a major step forward in breaking the stigma.
We're not twiddling our thumbs. If anything, we have our eyes open, you know, we're listening. We're heavily relying on research to help us derive best practices.
The resources are scarce, and there is still a long way to go. But what started as a silent killer is silent no more, thanks to the help of research like Janke's and an awareness once ignored.
If we continue to have these conversations and at least recognize the problem, then there is some hope that we can do something better.